GPU mining utilizes a computer's graphics processing unit, and it can be used to mine bitcoins, along with other types of crypto called altcoins. Additionally, this was a viral method of mining Bitcoin several years ago, yet there's still quite a bit of a buzz floating around the web that alludes to the idea that this is still a viable option for you. What is GPU mining? GPU mining is a means of solving complex math problems to verify electronic transactions using computer components, in this case, a graphics card. Miners who participate can either create digital coins or get paid for their processing power in a cryptocurrency. However, the world that revolves around what Bitcoin mining is these days has become very fast-paced, and if you do not have the latest ASICs miners to help with the calculations, you are going to get left in the dust. Meaning you won't make any money. So for the primary purpose of this guide, I wanted to go more in depth on what GPU mining is and how it all works so new miners can get a better feel for it all. By the end of this guide, you'll be a pro at understanding the complexities of mining with a GPU. However, before we begin, there are a few things you should know about GPU mining these days. Let's get started. The truth about how GPU mining works these days. When Bitcoin ASICs miners took over the Bitcoin mining scene, many miners switched their obsolete GPU mining rigs to script-based altcoins such as Litecoin and Dogecoin. The rush did not last for long, as companies rushed to develop script ASICs miners as well. As a result, script-based altcoins tumbled, messing up the ROI. ASICs miners are built strictly for mining and are considered one of the most efficient types of mining chipsets to date. For example, a single ASICs miner has the equivalent mining power of several hundred GPUs. Thus, the massive shift of miners toward ASICs hardware is easily justified. Even though GPUs give lower processing power than ASICs, they can still get utilized for mining coins like Ethereum, Zcoin, Grin, and Ravencoin, to name a few. NVIDIA and AMD make the most well-known GPUs as they offer a practical method to go into the crypto mining space without having to spend a ton of money. Furthermore, since they are relatively cheap while being flexible and customizable, you can run multiple GPUs on the same machine for different crypto coins simultaneously, or reconfigure your rigs to mine various coins based on what the most lucrative coin to mine is at a given point in time with little downtime or expense. GPUs have been the norm when it comes to at-home mining ever since CPUs became out of date for mineable cryptocurrencies like Bitcoin. For GPUs to give the power needed to have a chance at mining the Bitcoin algorithm efficiently these days, hundreds if not thousands of GPUs would need to be purchased. Although you can similarly switch algorithms, much like FPGAs, the costs required to mine via GPUs effectively can quickly add up to thousands of dollars. Getting started with GPU mining is comparatively easy, particularly if you already have a computer equipped with a gaming card. Building a mining rig is the main expense, as these can cost thousands of dollars. In 2018, mining of many significant cryptocurrencies was carried out predominantly using ASICs. Therefore, anyone mining these coins today using a GPU or CPU is trying to compete against large mining pools. These pools all use ASICs hardware that is specially customized to solve the cryptographic puzzles generated by mining algorithms. So, going up against them using a GPU is virtually pointless and highly unprofitable. Indeed, individual GPU mining of Bitcoin is no longer a profitable option, at least until the prices gain some upward momentum. But, still, some altcoins can be mined profitably using standard GPU mining rigs. So what exactly are GPU miners trying to solve? Before we can begin breaking down what all this means, it's essential to explain momentarily what cryptocurrency mining is. In straightforward terms, mining relates to the method of utilizing a CPU, GPU, or ASIC's processing abilities for the hopes of hashing blocks and validating transactions on what is known as the blockchain, which is nothing more than a public ledger of all past transactions. You see, whenever you start mining, your hardware used for mining receives tiny bits of information from the blockchain's network, which it then performs processes on. This process is known as hashing, and your computer power is used to help solve complicated mathematical problems, which ultimately earns you rewards. Therefore, GPU mining in this example is the means of calculating transactions and recording them to whatever crypto coin's public ledger you're mining on while attaching them to all past transactions. This record of retired transactions is known as the blockchain, as it resembles a chain of blocks in a digital form. The blockchain helps to confirm transactions to the rest of the chain as having taken place. What and how are GPU miners paid? Mining is also the tool used to disperse new coins into the network. Miners get compensated for any transactional fees accrued as well as a bonus of recently created coins for each block properly hashed. The purpose this serves is twofold. 1. Distributing new coins in a decentralized fashion. 2. Motivating miners to provide security for the network. As more miners join the network, the rate at which block creation happens gets increased. As the rate of block generation expands, the difficulty increases to counterbalance this effect, which can then push the rate of block production back down. Any blocks attempted to get created by malicious miners that do not meet the specified difficulty target will be refused by every miner on the network and thus will be rendered virtually useless. The mining network difficulty of any given mineable coin is a measure of how difficult it is to solve a new block, and this gets compared to the easiest that it can ever be mined. Furthermore, mining difficulty readjusts every so many blocks, which varies from coin to coin, to a value that is measured based on how fast or slow the previous set of blocks get generated. Given that everyone's been mining at the current difficulty, this controls the rate at which new blocks get created and provides a fair playing ground for all miners to win mining rewards. It also ensures that blocks don't generate fast, which would cause inflation to the currency. At the time of writing this, an Ethereum block is currently worth 2 Ethereum, which is valued around $360 USD. The miner or mining pool that hashes the block correctly wins this block reward for participating in verifying transactions across the network. This is what and how miners are paid. Why is GPU used for mining and not CPU? At the beginning of it all, mining with a central processing unit (CPU) on a laptop or desktop was the only option to mine cryptocurrencies and was done using Satoshi's original mining software. However, throughout the journey of continuing to secure Bitcoin's network and earn more coins, miners began innovating faster software and hardware, and for years now, CPU mining has been relatively trivial. These days you could mine Bitcoin for centuries using your laptop's CPU without earning a single coin. Nonetheless, we still give CPU mining credit to what it's becoming lately. Simply put, GPUs are much faster and more efficient for mining coins like Ethereum when compared to mining with a CPU. A CPU architecture is designed to be more of a Swiss Army knife with the ability to do a lot of different tasks. Whereas GPUs are engineered primarily for rendering graphics, thus making them extremely restrictive in their abilities. Due to the nature of their architecture, GPUs are only effective for intricacies that can be solved utilizing stream processing, as the hardware can only be employed in particular ways. This is what makes graphics cards so efficient at solving complex algorithms necessary for cryptocurrency mining, for the same reason they are good at rendering games on your computer screen. GPUs are capable of carrying out relatively straightforward computational duties but doing heaps of them all at the same time. And that, my friend, is what makes them so suited for mining cryptocurrencies. What is a GPU mining rig? Mainly, a mining rig can be a regular at-home computer or built custom for the specific purpose of mining. That's right, you can use your regular at-home computer to mine cryptocurrencies, although you won't be able to use it for much else while it's hashing away. Building a dedicated server is the better route to go for maximum efficiency and profits. If you're interested in learning how to build a GPU mining rig, then ideally, you'll want to construct your rig using the latest GPU mining hardware so that your rig doesn't become outdated in a few years. Because GPU mining rigs are much like an ordinary computer, they require computer components such as graphics cards, motherboard, CPU, RAM, PSU, and several other components. You can even build mining rigs with multiple graphics cards and dedicated GPUs. When appropriately configured, these cards can give you unprecedented performance. Don't worry if you're not all that savvy with computer parts, as all you need to do is hop in our Discord, and we can gladly help you out. What is the best GPU to mine with these days? There are a few aspects to take into consideration when deciding the best GPU for cryptocurrency mining, but the most critical one is hash rate. Although it needs to be offered at a price one can afford so that you have a fighting chance of getting an ROI. Lastly, its power consumption needs to be low enough to ensure you're not spending more on electricity than what you're earning. Three factors to consider when buying a GPU for mining. 1. Hash rate, the speed at which it can mine. 2. price needs to be reasonably priced to see ROI. 3. Power draw, preferably low wattage to save on electricity. Remember, the more electricity a GPU needs, the more costly it is to operate, which can ruin any chances of you making a profit. When it comes to which is better, AMD or Nvidia, there is some debate to be had there. The main argument is that the Nvidia cards come at a higher premium but offer a bit more well-rounded performance. Conversely, AMD seems to be the better route to go when it comes to mining coins like Ethereum or Monero, as they do tend to favor their chosen algorithms. In the end, the best GPU to mine is continuously changing, so be sure to check out our current list of preferred cards to use. Top recommended coins to mine with GPU. Until recently, the go-to answer for this particular question has always been Ethereum when referring to GPU mining. However, this coin was invaded by ASICs miners in 2018, which make competition in finding a block slightly unfair. The good news is that these days, the crypto mining space has a plethora of other altcoins that one could choose to mine with a GPU. GRIN is among the top contenders of best coins to GPU mine with its unique algorithm and unlimited supply. This coin utilizes the Mimblewimble protocol, which is said to be an equal opportunity for both ASICs and GPU miners while being extremely private by grouping its transactions into a single output. Additionally, Beam is another great choice as it has similar properties as GRIN. Lastly, I'd like to mention Ravencoin as another top choice as it has recently implemented further measures to prevent ASICs miners from mining its chain. The thing that seems to draw miners to Ravencoin is the fact that it's open source with a lot of development similar to Bitcoin but with more decentralized characteristics, thus creating a fair opportunity of GPU mining. As stated early on in this guide, it's not at all profitable to mine for Bitcoin no more due to its rapidly growing mining difficulty from the fast-paced development of ASICs mining. However, there's some workaround ways in which you can earn Bitcoins with a GPU and even a CPU by using special mining software. Mining software for GPU mining. Mining software is what makes your GPU or even CPU mine coins. Without the use of these programs, your computer or rig would be pretty much useless for mining. This allows you to easily control, monitor, and connect your mining rig to a coin's mining network or pool so that you can quickly start earning coins. Basically, what these mining programs do is tap into your mining rig's computer's processing power and put it to work hashing on a network of your choice. Additionally, there is software these days that can determine which coin would be the most profitable coin to mine at any given time. This software can take a lot of the guesswork out of the equation of knowing you're getting the most from your equipment. Today's list of mining software has evolved way beyond what Satoshi originally developed back when Bitcoin mining was first pioneered. To date, there are many ways to go about choosing a program to start earning a profit, with some being great, others being bad, and even some in between. Out of all the ones that we recommend on our list of Bitcoin mining software, one seems to outshine them all. Kudo Miner was recently developed with the intent of making mining a simple plug-and-play option for gamers and miners in mind. Although it's simple to use, it comes with a boatload of advanced features that even pro miners would be impressed. Kudo Miner's software can run a series of benchmarks to determine which coins you should mine to ensure you get the most profit from your hardware. Not only is it feature-rich for max profit, but you can select the option of being paid in Bitcoin instead, which relates to the workaround I mentioned earlier. Kudo also allows at-home users to easily configure their computers to disable mining when the PC is in use, so the computer doesn't run slow. GPU mining overclocking. Overclocking is a way to increase your mining hardware performance, and when it comes to mining, it really helps with increasing profits. Additionally, it can also be the leading cause of mining rig crashes and freezes, so you need to be careful when attempting to perform this action. Mostly what you're doing is accessing the hardware BIOS and adjusting its clock settings so that it can calculate more processes per second. Most manufacturers of hardware will warn you that this will void any warranty they provide. However, applying a modest overclock to your GPU can help increase the coins you can mine in a day while even lowering the overall wattage of GPU to save on electricity cost. This can also cause your GPU to run cooler as done correctly. The thing I really want to emphasize here is the fact you will need lots of research if you're not all that familiar with the process of doing this. The good news is that if you need help with overclocking, you can hop in our Discord and get some help. Lastly, I want to mention that these days, software like MSI Afterburner make doing this a breeze. Additionally, there is other open source software that can help find the best settings for your GPU rather quickly. I could go on to write a book about overclocking, but I'm going to keep it short for now. GPU mining profitability. Unfortunately, when it comes to how much profit one would make from GPU mining, there is no short easy answer. As with all crypto money-making investments, this one doesn't come without its own set of risks. With that said, the whole point of mining is to make a profit obviously. As a quick rule of thumb, never invest money that you can't afford to lose. The reason it's not easy to project what your financial outcome would be is the fact that there are many dynamically changing factors. For example, the cost of electricity varies significantly from country to country, and even in the States, it can vary widely. Some of the other factors include the price of the cryptocurrency you choose to mine, which can also vary significantly from day to day. Additionally, the price you agreed to buy your mining hardware will have a direct impact on when you'll see an ROI. The good news to all this is there are websites that can give you an idea of what you could potentially make before you decide to invest in hardware. Sites like WhatToMine have robust mining calculators that can determine many things like what the best coin to mine with a particular GPU and how much profit you can earn daily on your given electric rate and hardware. Although I must say, take its projections with a grain of salt as it's not an exact science. Use it as a guide instead and maybe even compare stats against other mining calculator sites like CoinWars to determine the route you want to go. GPU mining FAQ. Can you game and mine at the same time? Absolutely, you can game and mine at the same time, although it's highly not recommended and could potentially cause your GPU to prematurely wear and tear. Will mining damage my GPU? Mining with a GPU is relatively safe for the most part. However, there are ways in which you can cause damage to the card, like using too high of an overclock setting or operating in an environment with high temps. Can I buy used GPUs to mine with? For the most part, I have seen numerous reports of miners buying up used GPUs with much success. Just make sure to stick with the newer released cards, that way, you're not buying outdated hardware. Conclusion. I hope you enjoyed what you read here and I look forward to seeing all of you in my Discord. Remember, it's never too late to start GPU mining. Me personally, I really like this method of mining as it's one of my favorites out of the many ways to do so. The fact is that GPU mining has many opportunities to make a buck, and even if it don't pan out, I can always sell my computer parts to get most of my money back. As always, your feedback is welcome by posting a comment below. I genuinely enjoy hearing from crypto enthusiasts from all around the globe. Happy mining!